Welcome back to Full Throttle TV and the Blackwater Products USA Truck Series. Tonight we're at Bristol Motor Speedway for the Bristol 200. I'm Dean Doucette. In the booth with me tonight, Jared Carr. Jared, Bristol Motor Speedway and the Truck Series. It's going to be a good one, man.
Yeah, for sure. It's going to be high intensity and there's going to be a lot of beating and banging for sure.
And of course, for those here, Jeff Gordon in the booth tonight, not able to make the start of this race, should be with us soon. He had a meeting between iRacing and NASCAR and whatever. He should be in the booth anytime now. We look in here, Jared, we're going to take a quick look in at the points here in this truck series. We got Bernard Persson leading the way, Bobby Terrell 10 back, Casey McMullen Sr. is third back in third place, Russell Chernesky, David Shilhouse, Brian Helm, Terry Cooper Jr., James Torrey, Sherwood Williford, and Brody Hanna in the top 10 there. And tonight, you know, at Bristol, this is one of these types of races, Jared, that, you know, lots of points can be gained. Guys could have accidents, could get out of this race, could lose a whole 30 points. This could flip this whole point season up on its head.
Yeah, for sure, Dean. I mean, you come in here and you look at the top 10, the points. There's a lot of guys in here that are really, really good and haven't won a single race yet this year. And I expect it to change. I think we're going to have a first-time winner for the season. And I think we're going to see a big shakeup in points after this race goes down.
Yeah, very possible here, a first-time winner. Bristol can bring someone who's got a good car up to the front, can bring someone up there through luck and strategy, and maybe that'll bring us right into our keys to the race, and we'll see where our focus is tonight. We got pit road. You know, it's a long pit road. You got to go all the way around the track. Whether you're pitting on the front or back, you got to use both stalls. If you pit under green flag, you're looking at a possible four-lap loss under green flag racing. And my God, if a caution comes out, a lucky dog or whatever, a wave around, it just isn't going to help you when you're four laps down. Of course, we've got the tire rule here. You got one set on the car. You got three in the garage. You got 200 laps. If we get a couple of cautions, multiple cautions here tonight, this could play big. And of course, Jared, we've got track position, qualifying key here. Tough track to pass at.
Yeah, for sure. So when we take a look back at the past Bristol races, it's always been dominated by somebody. So somebody's gone out there and led, you know, 80, 90% of the race. Casey McMullen won the last time we were here at night. He led 197 of 200 laps, folks. So I mean, you got to get out front and you got to keep that track position.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, as you alluded to, it's been proven before. You got to get out there. You know, as guys now, gear up for qualifying as it's about to begin here. We look in at the race weather. Air temp at 79, track temp at 102. Fairly slick. We expect that to cool off into the 90s as we go along. But, Jared, 102 here. Not an easy track here to handle at Bristol, as we've seen several cars in practice getting loose in the middle of the turns.
Yeah, for sure. And you know, the difference between Bristol and, let's say, like Texas, where we got last week, besides the fact of that this is a short track, Bristol's concrete. So, I mean, even if it was a little bit cooler, it's still going to be slick. It's not going to lose its slickness at all. So I think that's going to be really crucial, is making sure you're set up to be able to handle a loose truck all night.
Yeah, most definitely key there. As as we look on the board here, Donnie Staubot's here, taking the early lead in that 99 truck. Good to see him out, truck. Brian Bliss there, Bobby Terrell, some familiar names as the board will continue to change as these guys get their laps in here.
Yeah, Bobby, you know, looking at all the practice sessions and looking at this practice, Bobby is a strong favorite tonight. I mean, he is quick and he's consistent. And, you know, if he's out front, he's going to be a tough guy to pass.
Yeah, he really will be. Bobby, incredibly tough to pass at any track. Jason Martin, good to see him having a nice qualifying run up there. Brian Conklin. But right now, as these guys finish up here in qualifying, we're going to take a short commercial break. When we come back, we'll set your starting order and we'll start this race up. Welcome back to Bristol Motor Speedway and the Blackwater Products USA Truck Series. Just taking a quick look in on the board here. We can see that Bernard Persson is on the top of the board, virtually tied with Bobby Terrell. Great run from these two guys, Jared.
Yeah, I mean, Bernie, I mean, that's a 4,000th difference between himself and Bobby. And then you have Brian Conklin just a couple hundredths behind them. So very, very close in those top three. Several drivers really, really close. I mean, a 10th here is not is a lot of time compared to some other tracks.
Yeah, and we see some guys struggling tonight. A Terry Cooper Jr., Casey McMullen, Sherwood Williford, all down in that bottom half. David Shillhouse way down there at the back. You got to think a couple of these guys had problems, perhaps lost control of their car during qualifying. They're going to have a lot of work tonight. You know, Jared, we talked about track position, how important it is here. You know, when you think about the lines that you run around here, it's the top side and the top side only. We've seen in past seasons a couple of guys somehow able to make the bottom work. A guy like a Brian Bliss made it work. Maybe a TJ Bartell or someone like that running the bottom. But very few and far between, and I don't think we'll see it tonight. Do you?
No, I don't. I think it's going to be a top heavy dependent race. I mean, if you watched that eNASCAR race last night with the Pro Series, those guys were running the top, and they found it really difficult to pass on the bottom. Now we do have a little bit more downforce in the Cup cars, but I think that it's going to be they're going to find it really hard on the bottom tonight.
Yeah, I think they will too. And, you know, when they come into this, it'll lead you into where can I pass if I can't use the bottom? And then you got a situation where you're talking about, you know, guys looking to use picks from lap cars and such as these things. And we've seen that. You talked about the pro race. We've seen that happen there as well, Jared, where guys, they just wait and wait until that lap car gets in the way. And then, bang, they try and get in a position where they can maybe squeeze in between where the guy's on the high, lap car on the high side and the guy trying to go low. And they get in that middle and maybe take that spot.
Exactly. But Dean, on the other side of that, man, we have had no repeat winners in this Bristol race. and our three winners. I mean, Michael Blackner starting up in fifth, but the other two, Sherwood Williford and Case McMullen, way back in the pack. It's going to be really interesting and entertaining to watch these two past winners try to come through the field.
Yeah, isn't that something that in this truck series here, you'd think with some of the talent that is here, we'd have a repeat winner, but we have not. And as you said, you're expecting yet another person to win tonight, and maybe it will be Bernard Person that takes it away.
Yeah, Bernard Person is a great pick. And then you have to think about Zach McDaniel. I mean, he's coming here. I mean, he didn't race the first couple of races, but he's coming here since then and just flat out dominated the races. So, I mean, I think he's a dark horse pick, even though he's not starting in his normal pole position.
Definitely. Yeah, not on the pole tonight. You got Zach McDaniel, Michael Chinesky there. And that leads us into our starting lineup. Why don't we go ahead and start that now? We got Bernard Person here on the pole tonight with a great time of 14.777. Bobby Terrell started on the outside of row one with a 14.782. He'll be in the four truck. Brian Conklin in the 37 will be starting third. The nine of Jason Martin will be on the outside of row two. Michael Blackner, one of our previous winners here in the trucks at Bristol, will start fifth tonight. Brian Bliss in the 18, starting sixth. Good starting position for Brian Bliss. The 20 of Russell Chinesky will be in seventh. Zach McDaniel, his teammate, will be on the outside of row four. The 14 of Lane Allen will be your ninth place car or truck. And Brandon Elder will be on the outside of row five.
Starting row six, we got Tracy Powers and James Torrey. Going down to row seven, we have William Long and Donnie Staubitz. Row 8, we have Tyler Marble and previous winner Sherwood Williford in the 16th spot. Row 9 has our last winner here, Case McMullen, who led 197 of 200 laps last time we were at Bristol. He is back there in row number 9 with Ronnie Royal. And then Terry Cooper and Rob Steven Loomis round out row 10.
All right, that's our top 20 as we're about to go green, I believe, here. So we'll forego the rest of the field here. We have about 35 guys in the field tonight, so we do have some strong cars back there. We'll try and get a look in them a little bit later on.
Yeah, just, you know, looking down the rest of the field real quick, we have Schildhaus and Brian Helm back there, so it's going to be interesting to watch those guys come forward.
Yeah, two great trucks, two great drivers back there. They got heavy work to do, and I mean, track position is so important here at Bristol. They've got to be kicking themselves for this awful starting position they have. Right now, as they're pacing through three and four, I believe. Yes, and the pace car is down and off the track. Looks like Bernard Person taking the high side here from the pole. Bobby Terrell down low as they head down into corner number one. The 8 truck getting that nice run on the high side. Going to be your leader. The 4 still stuck down low. Looks like we've got the 9 truck, Jason Martin, there making a move on the outside.
And Jason got in the wall there, and he's going to put some guys behind him 3 wide going into turn 3 there. Oh, we got a wreck, I think.
Yeah, we got an accident back here already. And there's still,
oh, still
no
wrecking.
Yellow on the track, and there it is.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. It looked like Jason just got a little bit aggressive going into that first turn. Unfortunate to see Brandon Elder also got some damage after that great strong run. He just cannot find luck this year.
Oh, Brandon Elder, very unfortunate. As we look from behind the 14 truck here, we'll get a quick look here. As you see up ahead, yeah, a little bit of touch up ahead. Try and get a better look at that. Maybe from the 20's point of view, we'll get in his cockpit here. As you can see, the 20 is down low on the track here. He's looking up. And as Brian Bliss just gets into the 9 of Jason Martin, I'm not sure if Jason come down a little bit or Biggie come up a little bit. We'll try and get a better look at this. As we take one more look, you see it looks like Jason Martin kind of came down, maybe expected Biggie to be a little bit lower on the track. And unfortunately, that's going to cause some mayhem for a few drivers out here.
Yeah. You know, I look at that again. It looked like, you know, again, Jason at the beginning got up in that wall, got up in that loose stuff as he got too high. And it kind of, Biggie tried, or Brian Bliss tried to get a little bit aggressive there and may have gotten inside of
him. Yeah, kind of a racing deal there. Hard to call. It's hard to know when you're not in the truck itself exactly whose fault it was there, but very unfortunate nonetheless. And maybe the biggest unfortunate here is the 51, Brandon Elder, currently coming off pit road. Hope he's not too heavily damaged. Brandon, a heck of a racer here at FTSR, has a long history of winning here, but also a long streak of no wins, Jared.
Yeah, Brandon is tied for seventh all-time in FTSR Truck Series wins, so we know he can get it done, but it just seems like this year he has just found himself in so many bad situations of not his own fault at all. So it's really tough to see him already got damage on this truck. But at the same time, Dean, you have to think that it's Bristol. I mean, you know, the damage isn't really going to affect too much.
Yeah, it shouldn't affect too much, though. But I'm pretty sure we've seen him grab tires there. Interesting, probably because he slid. You know, when you slide these tires in that, you will burn off up to 5 or 10% of your tire just from sliding around the track.
Yeah, and also we got David Schildhaus has made a pit stop too. So I don't know. I didn't see him get involved in that wreck, but he did make a pit stop.
Yeah, we're seeing David Schildhaus still on pit lane. And that's what we talked about earlier. Even under caution, you might go a lap down here with the length of this pit road. We see Jason Martin still down on pit road here. How unfortunate for Jason. You know, we talked about Brandon Elder, but Jason also had a good qualifying run, and he had a good truck tonight, so he'll be highly disappointed there.
Yeah, Jason, I mean, he's a great driver. He's typically a Cup Series guy in our league, but he has made, I think this is his second or third start in the Truck Series, so great starting position, just found himself at the wrong place at the wrong time on that one.
You know, let's talk about beneficiaries here as we look to a guy like the 42 of Zach McDaniel. We've seen him be dominant this year at times in the truck. Here he is. He's moved himself up to sixth place, and he's got that outside line as we're about ready to go green here as the car comes in. Bernie on the high side. Bernard Person getting another great jump up there. Looks like Michael Blackner is going to follow him through. Bobby Terrell will be lucky to fall in here to third place.
Yeah, we got Brian Conklin already trying to make a move on Zach McDaniel, and you see Bobby Terrell move up to the high side. So everybody's trying to get to that high side so they can get that run.
Yeah, definitely the high side's a preferred line here. And we see everybody down in the field trying to get there as we watch him come through the start finish line here. Bernard Person, your leader, Michael Blackner, Bobby Terrell, Zach McDaniel, Brian Conklin, top five.
And Jason Martin has come back out on the track. Unfortunately, he is multiple laps down, showing five laps down. Tough after starting third place today.
Yeah, really tough for Jason Martin. I feel so bad for him. But a long race here at Bristol. You can get laps back if there's wrecks. Right now, it looks like everybody doing a great job here, getting themselves sorted out. We might be in for a long run here. FTSR, great drivers, really known for their green flag racing. And it wouldn't be a surprise to see them finish out this race under green, Jared.
No, not at all. And I think that's going to be a big beneficiary to guys like Casey McMullen that we talked about earlier, Dean, that didn't qualify great. He has a track record here of being very successful, but he needs some green flag runs so he can use that tire wear that he's able to conserve to his advantage.
Yeah, most definitely. And we got a lot of great tire savers here. Guys like Sherwood Williford in the 33. Bernard Person at times. Zach McDaniel at times. Bobby Terrell, one of the best. I mean, he's shown more aggression this year and burned his tires up a little bit more than we're used to. But an expert driver as well. So many guys that could be doing it. But right now, the guy doing it, the 8 truck, Bernard Person leading the way. And we got ourselves a former winner here, the 22 of Michael Blackner, right on him here.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be a good battle for the lead. Michael's just not getting quite that bite off the turn as Bernard is getting there. I mean, Bernie's truck is just really gripping right now. But I expect that to change as the laps wear on.
Well, that's the thing. With the way Bernie's driving here, do you suspect, like, he's coming lower off the corner, putting a little more turn in that car. Is that going to help him or hurt him? It's a little shorter way around, I guess, but a little more bite, a little more heat on those tires, perhaps, Jared?
Well, yeah, I was thinking that, but he also, if you watch him, Dean, he's getting a lot higher in the turn, so he's arcing that turn a lot more than the guys behind him, so I think it's going to balance out. And you know how Bernie is. I mean, Bernie is one of those tire-saving guys we talked about.
Yeah, he definitely can be. Bernie, very good on the long run. Sometimes he gets out to the lead, he goes a little hard on the short run. Be interesting to see how this plays out. And right now, it's status quo. Bernard first in the lead, Michael Blackner second, Bobby Terrell in third, Zach McDaniel fourth, Brian Conklin fifth, Brian Bliss, Russell Chinesky, William Long, Donnie Stavas, and Tyler Marble up to 10th place.
And then looking at this, Dean, one of the guys we talked about earlier, previous winner here, Casey Nolan's already moved up five positions from his starting spot. He's up into 11th place, and he's trying to make gains on Tyler Marble in 10th.
Yeah, kind of all alone as we look in just in front of him with that battle with Tyler Marble. We watched Darnay Sabats here trying to make a move on William Long, and we talked about it. The low line, very tough, but these guys, seems like these two, the 99 and 48 here, kind of running the low line, especially the 99, really trying to work that bottom groove. That could pay off later in the race.
We got a pass for that position now as Tyler Marble has got on the inside. And Dean, both of these guys, Tyler and Dean, they come from a modified background. They're big in the SK modified, big in the Tour modified series here on iRacing. These guys are used to the short track battling. I'm sure they're going to be near the front when we call this thing done.
Yeah, it's a great point. They got the experience of these kind of tracks. Right now, we take a quick look in on the 12 just in front of them, trying to make a move on the 20 of Russell Chernowski. Will Long not able to get that done there. Very difficult passing down there as we see the 48 still trying to work on the 99 of Donnie Stavas.
Yeah, and the thing is the way that this track is, it's going to be really difficult. It could take several laps, and heck, Tyler may not even be able to get around Donnie because Donnie's getting such a great run off the turn. He's just got a little bit too much space there, and now he's officially cleared him. So I think Tyler's going to look at that again and try to make him force him down to the bottom lane.
Yeah, and this is where, you know, as this race wears on, and you perhaps believe you got a better car, but you can't get around someone, it starts to wear on you, and it starts to wear on you. And when do you, you know, use that chrome horn, maybe not even intentionally, just from the frustration, you're trying to get closer and closer to that bumper, and you get a little nudge in there. That can happen here at Bristol. You know, it's just a matter of time sometimes before someone does it, Jared.
Yeah, I think people are going to be patient. This early in the run, I mean, we're 29 laps in of 200, but I think, you know, if we were 29 laps to go, I think that you're going to see the bumper be given a lot more liberally there if you can. But Bernie right now is starting to gap up on Bobby Terrell, and they are catching some lap traffic. It looks like Daryl Spear is their first victim.
Yeah, we were looking down at the 42 and the 22 having quite a battle there. Same story as we've seen with the 48-99. That Zach McDaniel just not able to make that pass. Oh, another look. They have contact. They're around both of them, the 22 and 42. Wow. Caught that under live, but we'll take another look at that, folks.
Holy cow. That was, you know, I wouldn't have thought that would happen early, but man, oh man.
So frustration building early in this race. Don't like to see that, but let's take a quick look at it here. We'll look from our chase cam behind the 42. And as we go in here into the corner, the 42 gets the nice runoff, comes down low. Oh, and the 22 almost touches the wall, comes down a little bit, and just gets him there. So 42 really not trying to turn him. The 22 kind of came down the track, contact ensued.
That's tough for Blackner. I mean, he, like we were talking about earlier, Dean, he is a past winner here. He can get it done. I'm sure he's probably thinking, man, I wish I had maybe played a little bit less aggressive there. But it's one of those racing deals. I mean, that's just unfortunate for both those guys.
It really is. It's unfortunate. But up here in the booth, it always brings into that tire rule into action. Who pits? Who takes tires? We're on lap 33 of 100. Guys like the 42 are coming down. He has to. He's going to fix some damage, perhaps. Will he take tires? I think so. The 22's in with him, as well as that looks like, is that the 83 or? Yes, Jason Spear on pit road as well.
Yeah, and we also have Lane Allen and Brandon Elder on pit road as well. I'll tell you who's a big, big beneficiary of this caution. Guys like Daryl Spear, guys like Paul Sargeant, guys like Jason Spear. Those guys were within a half of going a lap down already in this race. So I'm sure they're very thankful that they got that caution.
Definitely, that's the case. And did that help anybody who was involved in earlier stuff? Did they get a lap back? Is it Brandon Elder still in this? It looks like Brandon's probably parked it for the night. That's really unfortunate for Brandon.
Yeah, tough break. And like I said, I mean, Brandon, I mean, he's got 6 career truck wins. He hasn't had the luck that he used to have, but I know it's going to turn around for him. And I'm just unfortunate that he got caught up in that early wreck.
The way it's looking right now, the 42 still sitting on pit road, not taking tires. He could be done for the evening as well.
Yeah, he's going to lose a lap here, it looks like, so that's not good. Same with Blackner. They're both going to lose a lap. And Lane Allen has lost a lap, too. So I don't know. I didn't see anything happen behind that wreck. I don't know if Lane got involved in something there or if that's from the previous wreck at the early part of the race.
Well, you know, we haven't talked about it here much, but we did talk about it in previous races about a few weeks ago where we've seen some of the damage that maybe not affect cars in the past here at that much at short tracks. All of a sudden now, damage like this, and maybe they're just too heavily damaged to race anymore.
Yeah, Dane, and just to correct myself there, Lane has officially retired from the race, so I apologize about that.
That is really unfortunate. So Brandon Elder and Lane Allen, both of Blackwater Motorsports there, they both retired from the race. Very unfortunate for that team.
Yeah, but you know, you look at this beneficiary thing again, you were talking about the tire rule and you're talking about the things that go along with that tire rule. I can't help but keep going back to Case McMullen, also Blackwater Motorsports. He's up to 9th place. He started 17th in this race.
Yeah, definitely a beneficiary. The 20 is benefiting, moving up the track. Several guys, Will Long, Tyler gained position. As the pace car rolls off, Bernard Pearson on that high line, one more time, takes him down. You're gonna get, it looks like the high side's gonna prevail again, and perhaps Russell Chinowski will grab second place away from Bobby Terrell. Will Donnie Salvis, looks like Donnie's throwing it in there hard. He's trying to keep that 4 pinned down low. I think he's gonna do it. And Bobby stuck on the bottom in desperate need to get to this high side before he gets freight trained by a few more guys.
Yeah, and Bobby is, you know, he's a patient guy. I mean, he's not going to make something happen that doesn't need to happen right now, but you got to think that he's maybe getting a little bit antsy getting pinned down there on the bottom.
No, and as we see Tyler Marble go to the high side, trying to fill that gap again, too, and keep Bobby down there. Oh, and he touches the wall a bit. That's going to allow Bobby Terrell to get into that high side.
What a run for Donnie Stavitz. I mean, we talked about it earlier, Dean. Him and Tyler Marble, they're big modified guys. They had that background, but he is up to 3rd place. This is a heck of a run for Donnie.
You know, Donnie come into the league. Well, I can't speak to when he came into the league, but he was virtually an unknown, running, you know, mid to back pack for a long time. And as of late, and I mean, he was improving. But here we are, about 3-4 races in a row now. We're looking at top 10s, top 5s. I mean, this man is on the verge of winning a race here at FTSR.
And Dean, as we talked about earlier, we have not had a repeat winner. Maybe his name's the next one on the trophy.
It would not surprise me. He obviously is a talented driver, decided to get a little bit used to the cars that we're running, coming from a different style of racing and those modifieds and stuff. And he sure is used to it. I mean, I think Donnie might even have won on a road course, so I might have to correct myself. He's a very talented racer, but getting used to what's being done here at FTSR and the trucks, the cup, and we also run an Xfinity series, really improving, looking great out here. But the one guy looking a little bit better right now, Bernard Pearson, continues to lead this race. He's got the 20 of Russell Chinowski right on him here. Donnie in third, Bobby Terrell in fourth. And Tyler Marble has made his way all the way up to the top 5.
Yeah, and there's a big gap, Dean. I mean, the top 5 has pulled well away from Brian Conklin in 6th place. And maybe Brian Conklin, he looks to be stacking up the rest of his field as people are starting to get 2 and 3 wide back behind Brian there in 6th place.
Yes, we look in here at this section of cars here behind him. You got Case McMullen coming by. You got Brian Bliss still stuck on that low side, trying to make it work down there. But a long, long line of cars here. As you see Tracy Powers try that bottom side. Always dangerous. You want to get by a guy you think you're faster than, but you could get freight trained up here.
Yeah, for sure. And Tracy is definitely a guy that, ooh, that's going to be, that was close. He holds,
wow.
He holds on to it. Wow.
Incredible move there. He had had enough, put a little bit of pressure on Brian Conklin, a little bit slower. As you see Conklin kind of moving down the track now. I don't know if he's trying to protect or he's just trying to get out of the way, but Casey McMullen's going to look to that low side now and try and make a move.
And Dean, you know, we talked about it, guys that qualified outside the top 20, Brian Helm. Don't look now, but Brian Helm is in ninth place right now.
Yeah, Brian Helm on the move as well. Wow, that is quite a big move by him. And he looks fast mid-corner there, just stuck here as Casey McMullen continues to work on the 37 and just can't seem to get the room to get it done here.
And you can definitely tell here, Brian Conklin is struggling with his truck. Something's going on there because Tracy Powers has already pulled out a gap and he has managed to get around Brian. And everybody behind him is just inching. We have Schildhaus in this battle. We have Sherwood Williford in this battle. Brian Bliss is in this battle. Nobody can seem to get a run on Brian Conklin here.
Oh, it's incredibly difficult on the bottom. But the more laps you do it, the more you find the quirks of the track. I expect Casey Remote to make this move as we see Schildhaus moving up in here to try and follow Casey McMullen through with Helm still struck on the high side with an incredibly fast truck.
And Casey McMullen's going to get it done. It's going to be interesting to see how he can gap out here, but I'll tell you another thing, Dean. Brian Conklin's holding these guys up. They're losing time to the guys in front of them, but they're also getting caught by the leaders at the same time, so they got to get something going here. Oh, we got a wreck.
Knocking it down.
All right, we got caution on the track. We'll get a quick look in on that.
Yeah, looks like two teammates got together, TJ and Will Long, both from Fury Motorsports.
We're having a hard time getting a look in on this. As we'll show you live as we continue to search for what happened there. So you see the 21 got into whom?
It looked like TJ got into the side of Will Long coming out of the turn there and stacked everybody up behind him.
Let's let this run through here and see exactly what happened here with the 21 as we see him riding in behind here. You see Will Long down on the high side. The 21 and TJ Bardell here on the high side. Trying to go above him. Ooh, and a little bit, didn't quite filter to the wall. They make contact. Ugh, tough one to call there, Jared.
Yeah, it looks like TJ might have just got a little bit loose right off the turn there. I don't know. It was very weird how that wreck happened.
We have a ton of people down on pit road, but our leader is not one of them. So very interesting here. We got Casey McMullen's in. I see Daryl Spear, Terry Cooper Jr.'s down pit road. Sergeant Bliss, Loomis is down pit road. Will Long, Gerringer, the other sergeant, Ronnie Royal, and Jeff Bratton.
Yeah, and these guys, I mean, my guess is they were struggling with the handling of the truck, and they may need to make some adjustments. Figured might as well get some rubber while we're at it, because these guys were run toward the back.
Well, I got to tell you, we're 57 laps into 200. It's 143 laps left. And I think, and some of these guys think they can make it. And that can be big. We know green flag stops will put you four laps down. And they're thinking, hey, I'm going to get some rubber right now.
Yeah, that's a good point. I mean, the fuel is gonna make it. I mean, you only really have to make one stop here at this race. And, you know, it's all about the tires. I think Bernie knows how his truck's going to be, knows how it's going to handle, and has a marker set out of when he's going to pit, regardless of the situation.
That's true, and it could benefit, it could be a mistake. Time will tell. I mean, I don't know what I would do out here. I know this, you can't pit under green. if you're pitting under green, these guys can make it now. It's over.
Yeah, I mean, there's too much of a gamble to pit under green, right? I mean, you know, you go in, you were talking about earlier, you could lose three or four laps, and then all of a sudden, you know, you caution comes out, and now you're down, you're stuck there. You're not going to get those laps back at all.
Yeah, absolutely correct. So we looked in on our top 10 here, Bernard Pearson, Russell Chernesky, Donnie Staubitz, Bobby Terrell, Tracy Powers, David Shilhouse, Brian Helm, Sherwood Williford, James Torrey, and Casey McMullen. With the last few there, new to the top 10, they're going to be quite happy. And I know Casey's got tires. He might be the first guy with new tires.
Yeah, I was just thinking that, Dean. I think he was the first guy. So I think that the first nine did not pit.
You know, and someone else to mention here, the 32 of Daryl Spear has shown up in 11th place. Good one going for him. And we're down in green here, and it looks like the 20 got a decent start there. Kind of spun the tires a little bit there, though. That's going to allow that 8 to grab that spot back, perhaps, as we're still going. And the 20 trying everything he can to get that lead away from the 8. Come off the corner, and he's going to get it. He's going to squeak in there. Great job by Russell Chinesky grabbing the lead on that start. One hell of a start. I don't think there was anything wrong with it, Jared.
No, and Russell knew he had to get it because this was his opportunity. Otherwise, he was going to be stuck on the bottom. He was going to be stuck behind Bernie, and he knew he wasn't going to be able to get around him. And now he can kind of get himself out front, get that clean air, which is, even though this is a short track, it still matters, especially on that tire wear. So great move by Russell to get out there in front of Bernie.
Yeah, awesome move. And you've seen him kind of spin the tires a little bit there, perhaps just a little more aggressive than Bernie was willing to be on, you know, 50, 60 lap old tires.
Big time. And we also, looking back through the field, Sherwood Williford is making a move. He is coming in a hurry. He has now found himself up to fifth place.
So Sherwood Williford on the move. And we're sure that Sherwood did not pit. Pretty sure he did not come down pit road, and Casey would be on fresher tires as Casey goes by Donnie Staubitz there. And this is going to be interesting now because I don't think Sherwood has new tires, but I know Casey does, and we're going to see what he's able to do with them.
Yeah, just confirmed, Dean. Sherwood did not come down pit road. It was Casey McMullen and Brian Bliss were the highest running guys that came down the pits, then followed by the three drivers that were involved in that wreck earlier, TJ Bartel, Will Long, and Roddy Royal.
So Sherwood Williford obviously was a strong truck, but on old tires here, as we look to see him continue to move on the pack. But right now, the 71 just cutting through this pack like butter. He moves by Bobby Terrell here. He's going to have to see
him. Oh, we got a wreck.
Caution is out.
Caution is out on the track.
Yeah, Dean, I was just going back through the field, and I saw getting hairy back here. We had some three wide action. Looks like Jeff Brayton got into the side of Brian Conklin coming out of turn two. Ooh, James Torrey. Sorry, James Torrey got in the side of Brian Conklin.
So we're going to take a look here from the back of, I believe, Jeff Bratton here. Come through the corner here, and then Conklin is stuck in the middle. James Torrey touches the wall, comes down a bit. We'll try and get a better look at that. Come out of the corner here, they're put three wide. Conklin feeling he had to go up a little bit higher than maybe normal. Torrey, who was a little bit really trying to stretch it high, touched the wall a little bit. Very unfortunate accident there.
Yeah, for sure. Because those guys, I mean, Brian Conklin was up in the top five earlier in this race, so now he's got some damage because he hit the inside wall pretty good there.
So this is the type of thing that can happen here. Cautions can breed cautions. And now we've got Bobby Terrell, Bernard Pearson, Russell Chinesky, all on pit road. But we have those other guys who just pitted. This is going to lose these guys all kinds of track position. They're going to be back in 10th, 11th, 12th, somewhere back in that range. And they're going to have to fight hard to get through against guys who really only have, what, two laps on their tires? This is going to be highly difficult, Jared.
Yeah, and, you know, you have Casey McMullen right there. He is in the lead. He was the guy that pitted the last time out. Brian Helm I did not see Brian Helm pit last time, so he may still be on old tires.
Interesting that Brian Helm is still on old tires. It could work out. It might not. Several of these guys now, basically everyone, down to two sets in the garage as we have 130 laps left in this. Casey McMullen, now your race leader. Now, this is interesting for Casey because Casey is not usually not a short run guy, but he's going to protect that high line. Will he get past? Will he be able to hold on long enough to where he's comfortable using up those tires a bit? Lots of interesting things happening here.
Yeah, for sure. And we know Casey can win here. I mean, he dominated this race. There's only two other drivers that led last time, and they each led two laps and one lap respectively. So Casey McMullen knows how to run this race, knows how to win this race. And now he's out front. That's exactly where he wants to be.
Yes, it's, of course, that is the spot for him. And they got Brian Helm, who you talked about. I think he's on old tires, though. But he had a hot rod. He was coming through the field. When we look in on him, we'll just check where he started again.
He started back in 23rd position. So, I mean, what a run. 22nd position, sorry. So, and then we have Matthew Gehringer right behind him, who started in 27th. So these guys making their move to the front.
Yeah, crazy moves by these guys to gain this much time. Unbelievable. All right, as we set the order here, about to go green, McMullen, Helm, Gehringer, Sergeant in fourth place, Jeff Bratton in fifth place, the other Sergeant
green
up
flag,
here.
Green flag.
New players everywhere. The green flag is down. The 71 gets a decent jump. 26 hanging with him quite well into corner number one as they race it off of two.
Yeah, this, they're not going to give it up too easy. Casey has got a great run off the turn there. Now we got Gehringer, who's on fresh rubber. He's two-lap-old rubber, coming on the inside of Brian Helm with his teammate Jeff Bratton right behind him from Wreck Havoc Racing.
Yeah, several guys on the move on that fresh rubber, that 11 looking stout. 71's got a nice big lead at this point. You know, for Bristol, any lead over a couple of tenths is considered huge, and Casey's got to be loving this.
Got three wide. That wasn't gonna work. They hold on to it though.
They're piling up now. There's a 12. Very unfortunate again.
Yeah, it looked like Kevin Sargent just got a little bit greedy there and got into the side of the 11.
So as we look again from behind the 55 truck here, come down the street where the 11 puts a 3 wide, or not the 11, the Sergeant puts a 3 wide on the 11. That was not going to work. Go ahead.
Yeah, sorry, Dean. Yeah, and then it's just unfortunate. Everybody's on the run, on the ride from there. I mean, looks like Bratton came up and got into Matthew, and then it's just chaos after that. Good trucks involved too.
And we see Tracy Powers getting collected at the end. Not sure, but many guys at the other Sergeant. Looks like Sherwood Williford got a piece of it. Wow. That is not good. That will not play well. And people's tempers will be flaring. But we have losers and we have winners. Some of the winners, you're going to have Bernard Persson. This is going to help him move through some of that traffic that he possibly couldn't get through otherwise. You know, it's going to help Russell Chernesky, maybe a couple other players like a Brian Conklin, I don't know, a few other guys who are right there in the mix.
For sure, and you know, it's going to help some of these guys that were involved in that earlier wreck, like TJ Bartell and Will Long. Now they're going to be caught back up, ready to go.
Yeah, definitely, Will. A little disappointing to see this happen to some of these great cars. I'm sure there's going to be some upset drivers as we see Schildhaus coming down to get some repairs or tires. Looks like Will Long still on pit road with Torrey, a few others. Looks like Williford down here. Conklin's in.
You know, and I think Kevin probably feels pretty bad about that. I mean, you know, he's usually a guy that's, you know, he's fairly new to the league. He's running out back most of the time. You know, he's getting some experience in there, and now he's up in the top five. He probably just got a little bit anxious, saw a hole, and went for it. You know, it just happens to the best of them.
It does, and I often talk about, you know, how when you're racing and you're throwing into, say, for Kevin Sargent, a top five position, and all of a sudden you get amped up and the energy going, and it's just something you're unfamiliar with, and sometimes it just takes getting there 2, 3, 4 times till you find a certain comfort level with it. You know, it happens. It happens to everybody, and these guys will move forward from it. Right now, a little hurt feelings from a few, and a little happiness from others. As we, like I said, Bernard Persson, you got Tyler Marble up there, TJ Bartel back in it. You know, some of these guys. Daryl Spear is having a nice night tonight.
Yeah, Daryl started shotgun on the field, so he was basically dead last on the field, and he is up to 10th place. So, heck of a run for Daryl. I mean, he has been coming along really great lately. As well as he's trying to learn some progression too. You know, he's a fairly new driver to the league as well. So good to see him up there.
Yeah, we've labeled him as one of those most improved drivers. NASCAR drivers don't particularly like that label, but I'm extremely happy and proud to see the 32 from Spear Motorsports having a good night and having several good runs in the last little while. Right now, McMullen, Helm, Sargent, Terrell, Stavos, your top five, as the pace car rolls off, and we're under green.
McMullen got a great start there. He's going to clear Brian Helm easily, and maybe Bobby Terrell can get around him as well.
Yeah, Bobby Terrell looking to lock in that high side, staying close to the 71, not allowing Helm any room to get that spot. The 71 takes off here. Definitely Bobby Terrell getting there, and Helm filters into third, squeezing into that high side.
And Tyler Marble, he just threw it down in turn two, and he's going to get alongside Russell Charnowski and maybe Brian Helm, maybe pick off two positions here.
Yeah, it's going to be hard to pick off two. Probably going to get trapped down there and eventually run out of juice. It's hard to say for sure. Tyler, a highly talented driver, but that's a tough move.
Yeah, it looks like he did get a little bit stalled out. Kevin Sargent, though, still hanging with these guys. So, you know, yeah, he made a mistake. Yeah, he took out some guys. But, you know, he's still hanging with this group. So
we've got the leaders side by side here. It's Bobby Terrell trying to ride right door to door as they come through the corner. They're off straight to the start-finish line, down into one. Bobby Terrell throwing it in deep, trying to get there. The 71 doing a great job on the high side, holding them off. A little bit of a wiggle there.
And Bobby has slightly fresher rubber, so you know he wants to get around Casey as quickly as he possibly can, so he's not burning his tires up. Ooh, a little pinch there, and Bobby's going to clear him coming off turn two.
Yeah, great job there by Bobby. Clean pass, little aggression, perfect drive. And it looks like he's yawing out a bit there in the corner. 71 trying to hang with him here. With only a couple lap older tires, you think he'd be good, but Bobby looking stout here as he takes the lead.
And that's the thing about that concrete, Dean, we talked about earlier. It builds that heat up really, really quickly. So you're going to be a little bit loose as it goes on the race. But it looks like Brian Helm starting to fall back. Not taking those tires is definitely starting to play its factor there.
Yeah, well, if he's still on that really old rubber, as Donnie Stavot's down on the low side trying to make it work, that's a tough spot down there. Yeah, and you can see that I think that's the 09, is it? Of Kevin Sargent right there as well, as he's trying to work on the 26, trying to show the patience. These guys really boxed in. And you can see, Jared, just a gap that they're losing fighting this battle here.
Yeah, they're running about a tenth and a half slower than, you know, if you look at Brian Helm and Donnie Stavot, tenth and a half slower than the guy in front of him, Bernie Persson. So, I mean, it's tough. And now Donnie Stavot is finally clear of Brian Helm, just time for a caution.
Got caution on the track.
Got Jangle back here.
Which number got involved there?
Still looking. Looks like Lane Allen might have been involved in that one. Oh. So we got it. Yeah, it looks like Tracy Powers got involved there. He looks like he got a little bit loose going into turn three.
So we look in here. Tracy down low, loose straight up into the wall, down into him. It looks like the 42 got some of that. Oh, a couple other cars. Unfortunate stuff there.
Yeah, that was a hard impact for Tracy. It was a hard impact for Jason Spear as well, who got into the side of him. He's got engine damage as well, so that's a tough break for Jason.
Jason not going to be happy. He had a lot of unfortunate luck as of late, and for quite a while. He's getting a little tired of it. The 83, I don't blame him. Very unfortunate for him. Helm is down on pit road. I don't think he was involved, but he's going to finally get some rubber.
And I think he was the only guy. Well, it looks like maybe Paul Sargeant might have come in as well, but
looks like Stephen Loomis down on pit road as well.
But we talked about earlier, Dean, track position. Was it worth Brian Helm to stay out the last two or three cautions we've had, run up in the top five, and now all of a sudden he's going to be starting back in the maybe even the 19th, 20th position?
Wow, we just witnessed a little problem with these pit stalls here at Bristol. It's Brian Helm having a heck of a time trying to find his pit stall, and he's forced, I believe, to make a two-tire stop there. I'm not sure how he would do that, but that's what it looked like.
Yeah, it was a very interesting exchange there. I'm not sure what happened, but I definitely don't think that was planned.
Definitely not planned, but he has to get back out on the track here before he loses a lap.
Yeah, and yeah, it looks like upon review, Dean, it looks like he did take four tires, so that's good news for Brian, but it was still a very, very slow stop.
Yeah, these pits here at Bristol, small pit boxes, lots of bend, so it's very hard to not only see your stop, but get that truck in position that iRacing deems that you're in a proper position. It'll tell you to move left or move right if you're not in the right position. And sometimes at a tricky track like Bristol, you just can't find that sweet spot, and boy, is that frustrating.
Yeah, because, I mean, especially at Bristol, you lose so much time here, even under caution. I mean, you got to get in there perfectly every time you go down pit road.
You really do. So we're looking at our top contenders right now. Bobby Terrell leading the way in that four truck. The 20 of Russell Chernesky in second. Casey McMullen in the 71 is third. Tyler Marble in the 48 up to fourth. Bernard Persson making his way back towards the front is in fifth. Donnie Staubitz in the 99 is sixth. Kevin Sargeant hanging in at in the 09 truck in seventh. TJ Bartel, Jeff Bratton, and William Long will round out your top 10. We see Bobby taking the high side too. Is everybody electing to start from the high side? He rolls down here.
Green, green, green.
And the green flag drops. A good start. Looks like Russell kind of gained an advantage there as he took the first spot. He'll have to relinquish that, I believe, but that might be a penalty for the 20 track.
Yeah, that was very, very close. I could not tell, but it looked very, very close that Russell might have gotten a little bit of a jump there, unfortunately.
Yeah, it's unfortunate, and if I was his crew chief, I'd tell him to give it back before he gets penalized. Well, that'll be for the admins and a post-race inspection, so to speak, but we'll see how that all plays out. Right now, Russell Chinesky, our leader, on the track. Looks like Tyler Marble's made his way up to third place. Donnie still hanging in there in fourth, and TJ Bartel, who's on a roll lately, has made his way up to fifth place.
That's a good recovery for TJ. I mean, he was involved in that lap 54 wreck. And, you know, he's been on roll lately, but his season started off absolutely abysmal for TJ. So, you know, he is just glad to be back on the racetrack and running the top five after being involved in the wreck earlier.
Yeah, TJ getting his first win in this past week in a long while. A great driver, having just, as you said, abysmal luck, really. Not of his own doing 99% of the time. But all of a sudden, you know, we've talked about this before in the booth, where you get a win, or for some guys, even a top five or a top 10, confidence starts to build. And all of a sudden, you're stringing two together, four together, 10 together. All of a sudden, you can't find yourself outside of the top 10 when before you couldn't get in it.
Exactly. And TJ's third all-time in FTSR Truck Series wins behind Bernie Person and Brody Hanna. So you know he has the talent. You know he has the ability to get up there and run. So it's good to see him recover from that rough start that he had.
Yeah, it really is. Well-liked driver here at FTSR. Everybody pulling for him. And maybe if he continues to win, that'll change. But really good to see the 21 truck doing well. Back up front, the 4 truck, Bobby Terrell, continues to stalk here, the 20 of Russell Chernesky, as they are 1-2 in the field and pulling away a little bit from Tyler Marble, our third place runner.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say, Dean. The top two have checked out. They're over almost a second, a little over a second ahead of Tyler Marble in second or third place there. So they are going after it right now and pulling out that gap.
You know, we've got to look back too and see, is there anybody on new tires? Is there anybody making a move here that just has that fresh rubber? And even if it's only a couple of laps, it could play big.
Yeah, Brian Helm is one of the first guys that had that fresh rubber. He is up to 11th place right now, but he seems to be kind of laying back. I mean, he hasn't really made a big move on Kevin Sargent or Jeff Bratton, who are in front of him. He's letting these guys battle it out, use up their stuff, and he's just relying on some green flag racing, I think.
I think that's extremely smart. There's a lot of traffic in front of them. They're too wide. There's no sense in burning that rubber up if you got nowhere to go. Mind your time, wait it out, and when the track opens up, then you can go. Like right now, he's 2 cars, there's nowhere to go. There's no sense in really pushing it as he tries to keep Will Long pinned down on the low side here.
Yeah, for sure. And, you know, looking back further in the pack, I mean, these guys back here, they're almost about a half a lap back. Already Brian Helm and that group.
Yeah, it doesn't take long here as you see Helm perhaps getting a little bit of a nudge to the 09 of Sargent there. I'm not sure, or he got loose, but Helm will take that position away.
And Brian's one of a super talented driver, new to the league this year. I mean, he has been tearing up the Xfinity Series, and you know, the Truck Series is definitely, and the Cup Series, he's been great in both of those. Hasn't won in either of those series yet, so I'm sure he's thinking to himself, like, let's let this thing play out. Let me get up front. I'm going to show everybody that I can get a win in the Truck Series.
Yes, we've seen Bernard Person just make a move on Case McMullen, who seems to be a little bit slow right now, perhaps on a little bit older tires, but Bernard Person has moved his way up to 6, and he is pulling away from this group. He was our early leader. He's got a really strong truck. We'll see if he can catch up to these guys.
Yeah, and you notice, Dean, there's a couple different groups that are forming here. You got the top two. They pulled way out ahead. Then you have 3rd through 5th. They're kind of in their own group. And then you have 6th through 11th in their own little group, as Russell, here in a couple laps, is going to be catching the tail end of the field. Some of these guys are involved in some wrecks earlier.
Yeah, the 20 truck of Russell Chinowski is still out here in front for a Bobby Terrell in second. As he said, the second group, the 48 of Tyler Marble, followed by Donnie Staubitz and TJ Bartel. Everybody kind of doing their own thing, as you said here. Oh, and Donnie's caught the wall a little bit. That's going to put TJ Bartel to the inside, trying to make a move and take away that spot. Donnie fighting back on that high side.
And Donnie's not going to let that position go without a fight. I mean, he knows how crucial that track position is, but it looks like he's going to have to concede there.
He is, but this has allowed that 8 truck to get right in this battle now. Extremely strong driver, extremely strong truck. The 8 looking to make a move already as he puts it down low on the 99. And you can just see the way that car sticks. He can get through those corners great. He's going to clear him in one turn. Great job by the 8 truck. Move him up. Now he's going to be into the 5th position, looking for a 4th and onward.
You have to wonder there, Dean. It didn't look like a hard hit, but you just wonder if it was just the right hit that may have caused some problems for Don there.
Well, it can not only cause problems with the truck and the handling, it can cause problems with your mind, and you need a couple more laps to kind of get back in your rhythm. I think that's what you'll find from Donnie. He'll get back in a rhythm here shortly. Just kind of jolts the senses a little bit when you touch that wall.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, and you can see he's kind of dropping off this back end here a little bit, maybe just kind of trying to regain focus there a little bit.
Right now, we stay of the 8 truck of Bernard Person as he clears Tyler Marble. Put him up to third place now. Bernie is on the move as Tyler trying to cross him over here. Bold move from the 48 truck.
And looking back at the lead real quick here, I mean, Russell and Charnowski and Bobby Turrell have cleared lap traffic. Did get a little bit hairy there for just a second, but it looks like they've cleared it with no problems.
We can see these guys are still matching lap times. It's still one car length, two car length lead here for Russell Chinesky. Bobby's just maintaining that gap. I have raced Bobby personally, and I can tell you in this situation, he is one of the most patient drivers I've ever seen. He will stalk you like this for 50, 60 laps before he makes a move.
Yeah, exactly. And you can see a lot of respect here for the lap guys. I mean, James Torrey pulled well all the way. So that's good to see. Didn't get involved in that wreck, group battle, I should say, between TJ and Tyler Marble.
Yeah, definitely good to see. As Bernard Person continues to work his way up here, we're looking at, you know, a 3 to 4 second gap to our leaders, as we'll get him at the start-finish line at about, you know, 3:20. Is the lead, and we'll just see if Bernie's making up some time here. I think he is. I think he might be the fastest guy on the track right now.
Well, you know, I was just about to say, Dean, the fastest guy on the track is actually Brian Helm back in seventh place. He's caught Donnie Staubitz. He's about turning about a half a second quicker than Donnie and about 2/10 quicker than TJ up in fourth place. So he is coming in a hurry.
Yeah, he's got the new rubber. He obviously had a fast truck early on even rubber. So watch out for the 26. I'd say the 26 and the 8 are on the move. And our leaders, of course, are going to be really tough to run down. But right now...
Oh, we got a wreck in front of the leaders. Wreck in front of the leaders. It was Terry Cooper got turned.
Try and get a quick look on that. It take a couple of minutes to pull up these wrecks at Bristol here. So we got it now. The 25 there, riding around, about to go on the outside of the 33, nothing there. He's up high, he's into the wall on his own, and then he's hit by the, is that the 21 you say, and the 17?
It's 81, Ronnie Royal looks like
81,
that.
Ronnie Royal got into him. The 25 just hitting the wall there, a little strange on exactly what happened there.
Yeah, it looks like maybe he just got a little bit tight. I'm not really sure. It was really, really weird accident there. But man, we have potential pit stops coming up here. Will these guys take that fresh rubber while they have the opportunity?
Well, several guys down pit road. Bernard Person, not one of them though. He's staying out on the track. Our two leaders, Russell Chinowski and Bobby Terrell, are down on pit road. Looks like Tyler Marble's on pit road.
And what a bold strategy by Bernie here. Bernie Person deciding to stay out, and if you look behind him, Brian Helm is the next guy. We told you he was coming, and now he has to stay out there. It's going to be interesting, especially with Russell Charnowski and Bobby Terrell coming in for fresh rubber.
So interesting, so dynamic the way this strategy is playing out. There is the tire rule. As we look in again on our keys to the race here, just to remind people, like the pit road, you don't want to pit on under green, you go like 4 laps down, but we got the tire rule. Guys got limited sets of tires. They start with 1 on the truck, 3 in the pits. Some of these guys are near their last set of tires. And of course, the track position, this is playing huge right now. Guys like Bobby Terrell and Russell Chinowski are going to lose chunks, huge chunks of track position. They might be back in 10th, 15th place when this sorts out.
Yeah, and it was a great race off pit road. Bobby Terrell managed to nip Russell Chinowski by just a hair there. And we got TJ Bartell coming out in third from the pit stops.
Well, this is actually going to play good. So this is the other side of the coin here. When you look at a Bobby Terrell coming out with fresh rubber, Russell Chinowski, great job by these guys on pit road. They're going to come out in fourth and fifth place. This is going to be a virtual no-brainer that they're going to take the lead right here shortly.
You have to think so, Dean. I mean, rubber is so important here, and it was a gamble by Bernie. It's a gamble by Brian Helm. But it clearly, and we saw this earlier in this race, these guys have a strategy in their mind, and they're going to stick to the strategy no matter what, when the cautions fall, no matter what happens on the track. They have something in mind, and they're going to stick to it.
Yeah, and I mean, this can flip on its head again with another caution. They probably assumed more people would stay out. They would have loved to have had a bigger pile of cars between them and those two fast trucks. But, you know, this could still fall their way. We get a caution in another 15, 20 laps, and now they pit and the other two don't. I mean, it just keeps flip-flopping.
Yeah, for sure. And both of these guys, you know, Brian Helm and Bernie Person, they are both teammates. So they clearly have a strategy. It's going to be interesting to see how they race each other here on the start.
Yeah, it really is here. I expect that these are actual teammates here, the 26 and 8. I expect them to get it sorted out.
Green, green, green.
As Bernie leads him down here, he's down and away. Looks like Bobby Terrell there, up in third place now, is trying to take that spot. 26 stuck down low is going to have trouble against some of this fresher rubber on the outside of him. Oh, and
ooh,
it looks
TJ.
Like the 21's going to get hit by the 99
right,
as well. Caution
knock
on the track. Once again, we're under caution.
And what a tough break there. TJ Bartel going into the turn got a little bit loose, and poor Donnie Stobbits, who was having a great run, just gets collected in that.
Take a quick look at this here. The 21 coming around the corner. Fresh rubber, just a little loose on exit there. Tony Goon, a good job of slowing down. No heavy damage from these guys, but a little bit. And they're going to lose a ton of track position. One of those keys we keep talking about.
Yeah, exactly. And that's the big problem, too. I mean, you know, there might not have been a lot of damage physically to the trucks, but think about the damage to the track position. Those guys were third and fourth place. Now they're going to be back in the teens, maybe top 10. And they also scrubbed a little bit of rubber off those tires by slowing down there. So tough break for both those guys either way.
And also a great job by them, by the way, of, you know, TJ kind of slowing that truck up, staying, you know, off the wall, staying off creating a big mess. Donnie really doing a great job of braking the way you should with a caution in front of you, causing minimal damage to these guys. They're still going to be hurt, but they're still in this race, and that's the key.
And that's going to shake up this field a little bit. If you look at the top five right now, you know, what... You look at it, you have Jeff Bratton up in the fourth place right now, just ahead of Russell Charnowski and Ronnie Royal, a guy we haven't talked about at all tonight, up into sixth place.
Yeah, Ronnie Royal up there. You got Bernie, Bobby Terrell, Brian Helm, we talked about, as we just kind of run through these guys, highlighting him. The 55 of Jeff Bratton. Really nice to see Jeff up here. Started in 28th, currently showing in fourth place. Russell Chernowski. You got Ronnie Royal that you just mentioned. He started back in 18th, up to sixth place. Tyler Marble, back here in seventh. Had an up and down night so far. Donnie hanging on to eighth place. And it looks like William Long will be in ninth. And Casey McMullen back in the top 10.
Yeah, it looks like Donnie didn't have enough damage to where it warranted him to come in. Didn't lose as much track position as maybe he thought. It's going to be really interesting to see how this run transpires for him because, you know, he did have to slow down. He did lock the brakes down a little bit. So hopefully he didn't burn off too much of that rubber.
Yeah, hopefully not. It can be really hard on these trucks when you slide them and lock them up. But, they got minimal. I mean, they did a great job with it, so hopefully not too bad there. But Bernard Pearson still leading this race here. He's got a little bit older tires than Bobby Terrell. Now, what do you think for this restart? You think Bobby can take him in the first couple of corners with that slightly fresher rubber? Or you think Bernie can hold him off?
I think Bernie has to do everything in his power to hold him off. We got 59 laps to go. That's still a long way. But it's not that long because, I mean, these laps are really short. So I think if you're Bernie right now, you have to do everything in your power to try to hold off Bobby, make him work for it a little bit, make him use up some of that rubber.
Yeah, absolutely. That's exactly what you got to do. You got to try and hold him down there for as long as possible if you're going to have any shot and clear him, hopefully. But if not, you got to make them work for this thing. But you got a lot of contenders up here. Jeff Bratton's up there. Helm's up there. All these guys hungry. As we see guys swapping spots back here, I'm not sure what's going on back there. But
yeah, it looks like there's a little bit of confusion on the start here. That's not a good thing.
never good to have confusion on the start, but I think it was just a two-car thing. We're going to be fine here. And it looks like Bernard Persson is ready to head down the checkered, or to the green flag, excuse me. Oh, and he wiggles a little bit there. You can see him. He learned from earlier on with Russell Chernesky and got a little better start. But Bobby Terrell with those fresh tires is going to power his way. I believe he's going to take it here in 3 and 4. Oh, and Bernie's turned by Jeff Bratton. And Helm gets into Bernie. Big pileup. The 12 involved. The 71 with a little bit of damage. Wow.
Man, oh, man.
Cautions keep piling up.
Cautions breed cautions. I think we talk about it time and time again. We had some great long runs in this race, but you know, we noticed we have back-to-back cautions a lot of times, and man, that's an unfortunate little wreck there.
It really is. We're going to go in the cockpit of the 55 here and just see what happened. We come through here. Oh, and he just had a bit of a run there and was a little indecisive whether he's coming low or not. Just got into Bernie. I don't know if Bernie checked up. It's hard to tell from, you know, when you're trying to lay blame or something. I'm not about to try that, but very difficult there to call exactly what happened.
Well, you have to think too. Bernie's out there. He's on older tires. Jeff's on new tires. I'm sure Jeff was probably thinking the closing rate was a lot quicker than he anticipated in that situation because he's got that fresh rubber. He's ready to go.
Yeah, he's ready to go. Now, again, we talk about the damage, not substantial, but the track position. Heavy, heavy loss of track position.
Yeah, and also collected in that wreck was Will Long at the end there. So tough break for Will. He's been involved in three of the wrecks tonight. So tough race for Will.
Yeah, tough race for a lot of these guys. There's going to be a lot of unhappy people in the pits. Bristol can do that to you. We see guys get out of their cars throwing helmets, throwing fists. We see it all at Bristol. And, you know, hopefully these guys get it sorted out here. We got 55 to go. Our new leader was our old leader, Bobby Terrell. Jeff Bratton now in second place, having a good run, just involved in that incident with Bernie. I know Jeff Bratton. Sure, he feels terrible about that one, but he's going to get here to racing. He's got a shot at this victory tonight, Jared.
Yeah, he does. And, you know, he was up there earlier with his teammate, Matt Geringer. He's the only guy left from Wreck Havoc Racing out there. So, you know, he's kind of carrying the flag right now. And Jeff's kind of had a disappointing season by his standards this year in the truck, sitting back at 20th in points. So, you know, he's trying to get a good run here tonight. But I definitely agree with you. I don't think he was trying to get into Bernie there at all.
No, Jeff, well known at FTSR for his clean racing. One of the true gentlemen of the sport here. There's no way he would purposely do that. That's just a racing deal and something that can happen at Bristol. And as you alluded to, cautions breed cautions. You stack up these cars, different rubber, time and time again. It's going to happen. So hopefully these guys can get it sorted out here under this one and we can get off and really see who can dominate here. You got to think Bobby Terrell here is sitting pretty. Some of his heaviest competitors have been fended off. You know, the 20 still there in third has got a shot here. The 8 is kind of fallen back after that incident. We don't really know what Jeff Bratton has yet, but Bobby got to be the favorite right now.
For sure, but you cannot count out, you know, Tyler Marble, who's been up front all night, Russell Chernowski, Donnie Stallbutz is back up there, Casey McMullen's back up there. I mean, this race is far from over.
Oh, far from over for sure. And the tire rule could still come into play. We know guys have one set left, at least some of them, and someone's going to use them.
Flag.
As the green flag comes down, sorry, I don't believe you're on time there. My apologies. The Ford truck comes up here on the high side. It looks like he's going to fend off Jeff Bratton. Jeff Bratton's going to have to fight Tyler Marble here. Well, he's still fighting the leader, but off the turn, Bobby's going to clear him. Looks like Tyler Marble's going to filter in on that high side. Bratton's going to be hard-pressed to filter, get in here on the high side, even into third place, as Casey McMullen kind of leaving a little room there. I think Bratton's going to be able to get up there.
Yeah, it looks like Casey just backed off just a little bit, maybe just trying to be a little bit patient there. Tyler Marble, though, he's hitting that low line. He has, you know, nobody's pressing him on the outside. He's just running the low line. So I think maybe Tyler's just trying to make something work down there and see what he can do against Bernie.
Well,
or Bobby, sorry.
We've seen this in past seasons. And I mentioned Brian Bliss. Brian Bliss was someone who made this low line work when nobody else could. It can be done, and perhaps he's been running a lot tonight. He's got used to it. Maybe he's laid a little rubber down there and there's a little more grip than usual. Tyler Marble doing a great job on the low line, currently in second place.
Yeah, and unfortunately, it looks like Bernie Person is back on pits. He has now gone a sixth lap down, so tough break for Bernie. He was doing so great tonight, but it looks like his night as far as competing is over.
Yeah, Bernard Person, just a total shame what's happened here. It's happened to Bernie more than once this season. Won't be happy, and just unfortunate for him. As we look in at the 55, the 71, the 20 of Russell Chernesky, and Donnie Sawbuds here battling pretty hard.
Yeah, this is a big battle here. It looks like, you know, I don't know. It looks like Jeff's got a pretty good gap there, but Russell is desperately wanting to ride Casey Mullen here, and he's going to get a run going into turn three there.
Well, we know Russell has a fast track. We know that he ran in the lead. He ran with Bobby Terrell for a long time before. We also know he has a possible infraction due from a restart we'll have to look at. But right now, up front, the four truck of Bobby Terrell in a very familiar situation. We've seen Bobby.
Oh, we got a wreck. Almost a wreck. Holds on to it. Casey McMullen got in the back of Russell Charnowski. And that allows Donnie Stobbins to get around and Jeff Bratton to check out of that group.
Yeah, we just caught the tail end there. Casey McMullen trying to three wide. And there's another wreck. Russell Charnowski. Oh, my goodness. The 21 airborne. And he's on his hood. Wow!
Two cars got airborne there. It looked like Russell got up in the fence. Unbelievable wreck.
So take a quick look here. The 21 down low. The 20 is up high. You see, everybody's riding status quo. Looks like the 20 just kind of bounces down a bit. Starts it all, and I mean, my goodness. That was airborne, the 20. We'll try and get another look from maybe a chase cam here and see exactly what happened here. We'll go with the 20, go on the chase cam. Look here, he's coming up. Just, I don't know, there just wasn't enough room for him there. I mean, he only had inches there and he was squeaking the wall. I don't know, I just don't think he was left enough room up there, Jared.
Yeah, looked like TJ might have made a mistake there. I hate to say that, but man, that was a tough break for all those guys. And Casey Mullen sitting right there behind him, he got a dashboard full of Russell Charnowski, so he got some damage in that, and he's down on pit road as well.
Let me look in the 8 truck still sitting here on pit road. Just so unfortunate for him. Now, as we talked about earlier, we've got winners and we've got losers from these situations. Right now, 40 to go. All of our main contenders are still out here, except for one. We see the 71, Casey McMullen on pit road.
Yeah, and Casey's definitely going to have some damage there. Brian Helm also came in. He had some damage from that earlier wreck. I'm sure he's trying to get touched up a little bit. But Dean, I mean, looking at the schedule ahead, I mean, we have two more short tracks. And if, you know, we also have Dover coming up and Talladega. There's going to be a lot of memory, if you know what I'm talking about.
I'm telling you, we had a rough race at Texas in the Cup car, which a lot of these guys participate in. You know, feelings are getting hurt, tempers are starting to boil. Where do we head? Straight into Bristol. Let's go to Bristol. That'll be fine. Let's go to Richmond, Dover. I mean, my God, Martinsville. These guys, I mean, there is going to be anger by the end of this season, I'm telling you.
And that's the beauty of the FTSR schedule. It sets up, you know, we have those 1.5 mile tracks. I mean, it sets it up perfectly to go right into these short tracks toward the end of the schedule. Really separates the boys from the men, I guess you could say.
It does. Also, the lucky from the unlucky. I mean, you got to have some luck. There's definitely skill involved. I mean, the one who comes out of these races in the lead, in the points lead, with great finishes at all these tracks, will definitely show his true grit and his ability to drive, but it's also a touch of luck, man. You've got to avoid all these incidents.
Yeah, for sure. And you know, that's the key in every championship, right? Is you have to be, it's not always the fastest guy that wins the championship. It's the guy that's most consistent and keeps his nose clean at the end of the day.
Absolutely. As Bobby Terrell leading them down the way. Tyler Marble down that low line. He's been running it all night. Can he make it work? And we got guys like Casey McMullen and Brian Helm on new tires a few cars back. We'll see how this all plays out. Right now, green flag is down and away. Bobby Terrell down into one. Looks like Tyler not quite getting the jump he would have hoped for. Bobby's probably going to succeed on this high line here, but I'm telling you, that 48 is doing a great job on the low line.
Yeah, he's not going to give up without a fight. I mean, these guys, all of these guys are battling hard for a win. I mean, it's just, it's coming down to go time at this point.
You can see Tyler really wanting to use the whole track low to high. And if he's got enough room, he can be really fast. But Donnie's right there, ready to fill that high side if it opens up for him.
Exactly. And if you look at these top three trucks, Dean, none of them have ever won in a short track in the truck series. So they're desperate for a win in this short track's start of the season here. And Donnie hasn't even won the truck series. So you know he's thirsty for his first career win.
Yeah, Donnie definitely thirsty. He's having a great night here, sitting in third. Someone we haven't talked about too much, Terry Cooper Jr., up to fourth place. Obviously, with a damaged truck, had some incident problems early in the race, has persevered. He's up to fourth, Bratton in fifth. Looks like Sherwood Williford, Will Long. And then you got Casey McMullen here with those fresh rubber, him and Brian Helm, looking for room to work through this traffic.
Yeah, you know Sherwood, and you know Casey McMullen, they're both going to be coming to the front. Oh, we got contact.
Will and Sherwood contact. Looks like Casey squeaks through. We're still green. Great job of saving it by the 33 truck. Great job by 71 showing some patience. Not sure what happened exactly there, though, but we had contact, which made the 33 loose there. Great job, Gavin.
Poor Sherwood tonight has been involved in every wreck, and he's not even been close to the action. He's just been getting beat up on all race long. So tough there, but good job holding on to it. Looks like he's got himself back under control. And Kevin Sargent trying to make a move on Brian Helm back here.
Yeah, Kevin Sargent been strong. He's had a little trouble tonight with an accident. But other than that, extremely strong truck by Kevin Sargent. Having a really good race tonight.
That's good for him. I mean, you know, he needs that experience. He needs a good run. He's one of those guys, you know, kind of has struggled this year a lot. It's good to see him in the top 10, regardless.
It really is. I'm really happy for him, and I hope he continues here. As he's battling hard here, he is not allowing that 26 to use that low line because he keeps putting pressure on him. But the 26, perhaps with that damage, not as strong as he once was, Jared.
Yeah, I mean, he did get hit right in the front end. I'm sure it's going to take a little bit of that downforce away, make it a little bit harder to get in the turn, a little bit harder to get off the turn, probably a little bit tight in the middle there, and, you know, it's probably a little bit of a struggle for him right now.
As we've seen Casey McMullen just move by the 55 of Jeff Bratton, put him up to sixth place. He's got those fresh rubber. He's got a shot here, but with 25 to go, Bobby Terrell leading the way. This is a tall order for Casey McMullen or anybody else to run down this four track.
Yeah, and you got Will Long. He's moved up to fifth place. He has a short track win in his belt. He won at Iowa a couple seasons ago. So, I mean, he is somebody that you can't count out here, especially if we get a late caution here. But he's starting to make some gains toward the front.
Yeah, Will having himself a decent night here. You just seen him with Sherwood there as they had contact. But he's got it straightened out, and he's hunting down this 25 pretty handily. I think he'll move right on by Terry Cooper when he gets there. Terry Cooper Jr. with a heavily damaged truck, having a great run here in fourth place. Just, I mean, this is what you got to do at Bristol here, Jared. You got to manage these wrecks. You got to manage your tires, your track position, and you got to drive a broken car.
Exactly. And Terry Cooper, I mean, he has come on real strong. He had a great run going at Texas. Was involved in some late race accidents there, really hurt his chances there. But I mean, he's doing really good. This truck looks like it needs to be in a junkyard, not on a racetrack.
It really does. And he fends off the 12 for now. Will Long getting a little frustrated, can't move by. This is Bristol, baby. It's not easy. You got to do it somehow, some way. And he's going to regroup here and try and find another way as Casey McMullen closes in on this group.
Yeah, we're getting down to 19 to go here. So every position is going to be very crucial. And you know Terry Cooper, he's wanting a top five. He's trying to finish good in the points, obviously. Will Long's right there. He's had a tough season, just like most of his Fury Interactive teammates have. So it's been really difficult for them. They all want every position, every point right now.
Yeah, they really do. Nobody's going to give at this point. You see Will Long edging up to that bumper now, perhaps getting a little bit frustrated. When we get down to these last laps, this is when the frustrations start to come. The bumpers come out. You know, the 12, I don't know. He's trying his best. He's getting a good run off, but just no room. He just does not want to go down to that really low side. He just can't make it work. As Casey McMullen, this has allowed him to crawl right into this match.
And I know we're focusing a lot on that battle, because Bobby Turrell has checked out. He's got a 2.5-second lead over Tyler Marble. But, Dean, we're getting down to it. We got 15 to go. He's going to catch lap traffic, I think, before the end of this race. Is that going to allow Tyler Marble to catch back up?
You never know. It could. It really depends on whether they're single file or double file. As we look back at Casey McMullen, we've seen this happen to him before. Fresh rubber, nowhere to go, as he was locked as those battled two by two. And now, finally, the bottom opens up, and you can see the 71 starting to assert himself. But Brian Helm now making a move. Both these guys on fresher rubber. Casey McMullen clearly does not like the bottom. That truck getting wiggly. This is not playing well for him. Maybe Brian Helm is going to take this spot away from him now.
Brian Helm is just driving the wheels off of it. He's knocked down the wall a couple times, and he's, at this point, I mean, he's probably thinking, I'm just going to go for it at this point. He gets in the back of Will Long, though, and Will holds on to it, but that might allow Casey to make a move here.
Well, Will actually hit the wall there just before that corner, and you can see this pressure of being in this heavy battle. We see the 71 get a little bit loose there, perhaps almost a little contact as he tries to fight into the high side. 71 not able to work the bottom. And oh, and they're squeaking high. The 26 up there rubbing the wall to get by the 71. Casey McMullen's truck just not good enough to work the bottom. As we see Brian Helm now work it back up front. Bobby Terrell in this heavy, heavy traffic here, and this is definitely slowing him down as Bernard Persson make a real classy move there, pulling over off the track surface even to kind of let Bobby get through. Really classy from the 8 truck.
Yeah, looking at this battle for, 5th, 6th, and 7th here, I mean, I have to recant, that Kurt Busch, Ricky Craven race at Darlington where Larry McReynolds is like, these cars are driving terrible right now. I have to think, Dean, these trucks right now are driving terrible. These guys are just on it right now. They're damaged. They're probably wanting to get done with the race. I mean, they have to be on the edge right now.
They're definitely on the edge. And, you know, the guy who got through this group, 26, has checked right out. So Brian Helm, a solid fourth place right now. Bobby Terrell is completely checked out. 2.5-second lead over Donnie Sabas, who's taken over that second place. We missed that. Donnie Sabas actually able to get by the 48 car truck here. Good for him, up to second place.
Yeah, and it wasn't much of a move. I mean, it looked like Tyler just knew that he didn't have anything for him because Donnie made it look really easy on the outside there.
Yeah, Tyler really set up for the low side. It's a smart move, and he's having a heck of a good night. Third place, nothing to sneeze at, but Bobby Terrell out front right now, virtually untouchable. Without a wreck here, without any problems, this is Bobby's to win, and I think he's going to do it. We look check back in at that Casey McMullen, and looks like the 25 Terry Cooper Jr. has fallen off. Perhaps a little bit of an incident occurred there, we're not sure, but these two, Will Long and the 71, continue to fight here.
Yeah, and you looking at Donnie Stavitz coming through the pack here. They're fighting some heavy traffic. Tyler Marble's right back up on him. And then right in front of him, Jeff Bratton looks like he's going to make a pit stop. I mean, he was running the top five at one point in time. No, he didn't make a pit stop. So he's staying out there, but he's dropped all the way back to 13th place, a lap down.
It's unfortunate for the 55. He was having a heck of a run up there. So you ride around with Donnie for a minute there, but we got to get back out front. Bobby Terrell leading this race, about to take the white flag here, and we're on one to go. The four truck of Bobby Terrell gonna win this race here. He comes down the back stretch, heads down into three, nice and clean through here, nice and easy. Our four truck, Bobby Terrell, gonna win the Bristol 200 here on Full Throttle TV with Blackwater Products USA. Another win for Bobby Terrell. A great job by him. Really nice to see him back in the winner's circle.
And Brian Helm nicks Tyler Marble there on the last lap. So good run there for Brian Helm getting up into third place.
Yeah, Brian Helm fought hard for that third place. He had a really good truck. You know, lots of guys with good trucks who maybe should have had better finishing order. None more than Bernard Persson in the 8 truck. You know, a few others. But good on Brian Helm getting a third place here as we watch Bobby Terrell here sit at the start-finish line, about to celebrate a great victory here from the 4 truck. Boy, I got to say, Jared, what a tough night tonight for these guys. I mean, this is not typical of FTSR. These guys, lots of wrecks, lots of hard racing, and the 4 truck persevered.
Yeah, you're right, Dean. I went back and looked. It looked like Tyler Marble might have had a little bit of help finishing fourth place tonight from Brian Helm. Looked like there was a little bit of contact there. And we talked about it at the beginning of the race. There are a lot of guys on edge. We go into a short track. We're going to the short track stretch of our season. And this is just one of those races where you could definitely tell that the tempers were on edge tonight.
Yeah, I'm sure. You know, I don't know if we're going to get any of the hot-headed drivers, let's say, in our interviews, but we will get interviews from our top three, and especially from Bobby Terrell, our race winner, and we'll run through our whole finishing order here, and we'll do all that right after this short message.
Coming up to the line, being chased, and it was Braden Johnson.
Unbelievable finish.
It was 1/1000th of a second between them.
Green flag in the air. We are racing in the 2020 24 Hours of Daytona.
They go door to door for the feature race lead here on the last lap of the race. For the race lead in the final corner at Homestead.
Down the back straightaway, 3 wide again for the race lead. This is unbelievable stuff here tonight.
Aloma is going to have to be very deep on the brakes, and he is very deep on the brakes. It's side by side through the corner. This is for the win.
It'll be side by side. Davies low, Ottinger high. To the very inside is Garrett low. 4 wide at the stripe.
For Audi's win here on this outside line, neck and neck. Who's gonna back out? Does anyone back out?
Verstappen starts to squeeze on the inside, and now he'll try and straight line it. Goes under the apron, drag race to the line. It's so close to call.
Welcome back to Full Throttle TV, the Blackwater Products USA Truck Series here at Bristol Motor Speedway. What a race we had, man. So much going on, Jared. Different strategies. Guys pitting at different times. Multiple wrecks. Different cars in the lead pack. But one guy who was always up front was Bobby Terrell. And, I mean, what a race, Jared.
Yeah, it was a heck of a race. And, you know, we talked about at the top of the show, Dean. We have never had a repeat winner here at Bristol. And guess what? It continues on after this race.
It's really quite unbelievable. You know, you mentioned it, and here it is. It happened. I mean, you would have thought Bobby might have got one, but no, he's not. This is his first here, so congrats to him. And we'll see next time if someone can do it. Right now, let's run down our finishing order here. As we look through our top 10 here, Bobby Terrell in the 4 truck, our race winner tonight. Just a masterful job. Clean truck all night. No incidents. Just great job all around. Donnie Staubitz, fantastic finish for him. Just that close to getting his first oval victory here at FTSR. He's going to get one. He's been nailing down top fives like they're nothing lately. Really happy for him. Brian Helm persevered. Fantastic job by him. He'll take third in the 26 truck. Tyler Marble running that low line up there all night. 48 truck. Just fantastic job in fourth. Will Long persevered for fifth place. Casey McMullen, Terry Cooper Jr., Sherwood Williford, Kevin Sargent. Nice finish for him in ninth. Ronnie Royal grabbed 10th place.
Yeah, and then we have James Torrey, Daryl Spear, Jeff Bratton, Brian Conklin, and Stephen Loomis. Those are the last guys, Bernard Person and Matthew Gehringer are the last guys running in 17th. Everybody after that was out of the race.
Yeah, we had a lot of guys with incidents there. It was TJ Bartell having a great night again, wrapped up in an incident. Jason Spear got caught up. I don't know what more we can say about those two. They get caught up in so much stuff. It's just so unfortunate for him. Michael Blackner was having a really great run early on. Jason Martin and Brandon Alder never even got out of the gate. I mean, they had great trucks tonight and qualified well, and just right off the bat, they got involved in incidents. Just so many storylines could have happened. The one we have, though, is the, Bobby Terrell running down, winning this race. You know, Russell Chinowski was up there, and many others were up there. All in all, just a good night at the track. I mean, good for broadcasting, good for watching. The tempers are going to be flaring, though, Jared, and we've got more short track action coming.
Exactly. We talked about it a little bit earlier, Dean. We have Richmond coming up next. Then we go to Talladega, and then we have Dover and Martinsville to finish out this truck season. I mean, hopefully there's no payback at Talladega, but you have to think in your mind, there's going to be some aggressive no-give racing at Richmond.
Oh, there will be. I mean, it's just inevitable. These things build up over time, and it's going to happen. You know, right now, though, let's talk to our third-place finisher, Brian Helm. Congratulations, Brian, man. A great job of perseverance tonight. You're going to take home third place.
Yeah, thanks. I really think I kind of got Tyler there on that last lap. He should have been the guy here right now. I mean, I overdrove the corner a little bit, and it clipped him. But, yeah, it was a fun race, and we were doing pretty good on the strategy, I thought, but maybe a hair off from Bobby.
Yeah, well, talk a little bit about your truck. Like, we've seen you at different times in the race just looking like perhaps the best car on the track. There were several good trucks, but it looked like you might have had something for them. You said your hair off. I'm not too sure, Brian.
No, we had a great set. Team Spear built a great set this week. I mean, thanks to all the guys over there. As a strategy, I like pitted one stop too late, and I didn't have enough time to get back to the front.
Yeah, we talked a lot about it in the booth. There's so many cautions, so many different strategies going on, and track position being so important here. You know, one bad pit and, you're back in 12th or 15th. So hard to pass. Talk a little bit about trying to work through some traffic or slower car trucks. I mean, trying to work the bottom was nearly impossible, Brian.
Yeah, the bottom was pretty much bonsai and hope you clear them. I mean, really, that's what I was doing. And, even if you had, way fresher tires. So I know that Bernie and I both pitted about the same time, and he obviously had an issue because he got hung up in like a wreck, so it was just a little bit of luck and a little bit of go and have a good car at the end, and that's how I ended up here. And again, I want to say sorry to Tyler because I don't run that way, but I kind of clipped him.
Yeah, it happens here at Bristol, Brian. We've seen much worse out on the track tonight, so I wouldn't be too worried. We really feel bad for your teammate, Bernard Person, who had a tough finish there. Perhaps the best truck out here tonight. Really hard to say. Wouldn't really have the runs to sort it all out, but Bernie having a little bit of a tough night, Jason having a tough night, but Team Spear is going to be happy with your performance tonight, man. Third place. Congratulations again, and if you want to shout out anyone, now's the time, brother.
Yeah, really. I just want to thank Team Spear for bringing me on board. All them guys are really helping on the sets, and we really got a good thing clicking right now. We're finishing up front on a regular basis, and pretty much enjoying what we're doing here. And thanks for you guys for broadcasting it.
All right, Jared.
Go ahead, Jared, if you want to say something.
I was just going to say congrats, Brian. I mean, it was really interesting watching you work your way through the pack. Now, you and Bernie, were you guys working on the same strategy? I noticed you guys kind of were pitting at the same time together.
Yeah, I mean, I was kind of like, yeah, at the beginning of the race, I'm not going to the pits under no circumstances until they start passing me. And so, and then we went in together, and then it turned out that we went in again because we kind of ended up on the same strategy at the end. But yeah, I mean, we were kind of working together and talking to each other on the radio.
All right, Jared. That's Brian Helm, third place. Fantastic job by him persevering through this chaos of the night.
Yeah, thanks, guys.
All right, man. Brian Helm once again. Second place finisher tonight. That's going to be Donnie Stabas. And I believe you caught up with him, Jared.
Donnie, what a run, man. I mean, you were up and down in this race. You got involved in a couple of wrecks. Take us through your night. I mean, what a run. Second place.
Yeah, thank you very much. It was a long night. The track position was so tough, or so important that, we got caught on the bottom a few times and were able to make a couple passes. But so much is luck here and avoiding stuff. And, we just, picked our way to the top there, tried to stay as patient as we could, didn't make any mistakes on pit road, which is tough here. It's so slow. So you really gotta watch your P's and Q's on pit road. And, we just had, super fast truck tonight. Blackwater team gave me the best truck I could ask for. If it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be up here, for sure. They do a phenomenal job, and I can't thank them enough. I'm so grateful for them. But yeah, it's great, man, to get a second at Bristol. I'm stoked.
So be honest with me. Could you taste the victory at all? Could you taste your first FTSR Truck Series victory tonight?
It was gonna be tough. Bobby's so fast, and it seemed like he just kept getting faster as the night went on. And he got away, there at the end there. Him and Tyler were battling a little. I'm like, oh, we got about 30 laps, truck, cool my tires and hang back a little bit, and hopefully they burn their stuff up. I think Tyler might have, because we were able to run him down and get by him. But Bobby was so far ahead by that time, and then there was some lap traffic in the way, so it made it a little difficult to try to catch him. But even if I was on him, it's one thing to catch somebody here, but passing is so tough, especially on older tires, that it would have been a real chore to do that. And congratulations to Bobby on the win. He was the dominant truck for sure tonight. And thank you to FTRS for everything they do. With the league, appreciate it very much.
Awesome, man. It was a great run from you. Now, I have to think, man, great run here at Bristol. I know you don't run the truck series too much, but are you looking forward to the back end of the schedule being a lot of short tracks with your background?
Yeah, we're gonna run a limited deal with the trucks this year. It's a lot to try to run three series and keep the family happy too at the same time. So we're concentrating mostly on Cup and Xfinity in the trucks once in a while. But I'm gonna run as much as I possibly can. I love running the trucks and running with these guys. It's a group of professionals for sure, and I'm lucky to be racing with them.
Well, congrats, Donnie. Great run, and hopefully we'll see you back out there the rest of the season.
Thank you. Appreciate it very much. Thank you to everybody and for tuning in, FTSR for what they do, for making this the greatest league.
All right, that's Donnie Stabat, our third place finisher. Jared, Donnie, we talked about it earlier. His confidence has got to be growing. I'm telling you, this is like the fourth or fifth time in recent races we've seen him in the top five or top 10 when he hadn't been there before. So Donnie Stabat is someone on the rise, someone to watch in the future, but someone who's one better and someone who's always someone to watch, Bobby Terrell in the Ford truck, our race winner tonight. Congratulations, Bobby. Bobby Terrell, you got ears on.
Yeah, thanks, guys. I appreciate it. Wrong button.
the 10-4. Bobby, heck of a race tonight, man. Clean truck. No trouble for you tonight. Trouble on the track everywhere. Talk about some of the... Let's go back to, you know, you and Russell there on the restart. Russell taking you on the high side there. We're not sure if it was quite, you know, or taking you on the low side. I can't remember exactly how it went. But talk a little bit about that battle.
Yeah, you know, I felt like, you know, once things got sorted out, I thought Bernie had, you know, a good truck. Russell had a good truck. There was two more that I thought, you know, that had good trucks and would be up there. Russell surprised me. You know, he could really get that low line and make it work. I don't really know how he was making it work on the start like that, but it, you know, it's twice I've seen him pass people on the low side. I think I passed maybe one or two people on the low side, you know, all night because I had fresher tires. But this one feels good because, you know, last week just so terrible, missed the setup so bad, you know, and tonight I don't mind telling you. I mean, everything kind of worked out, got track position. And that last adjustment I made in the pits, man, that thing came alive.
Yeah, track position being huge here. Adjustment, that's, you know, great to hear for you too. I mean, they can make a big difference, especially as the rubber's in and the track temp changes. But you did a great job with that. You know, we watched, you talk about the low line. We watched Tyler Marble also able to run the low line a little bit. And he hung around the top five all night long. But there was several trucks. You know, you talked about Bernard Persson. We all feel bad for Bernie. Perhaps he had something for you. He was a really strong truck. I mean, early on in the race, I think Bernie was kind of you and him out front at the beginning of this race.
Yeah, I mean, I think I got into second, and I was reeling him in a little bit. And then that first caution come out. And then, like I said, like I stayed, you know, pretty much in the top three to top five, I guess, all night. But I could tell that I could gain, you know, and then I would lose some. But then I started thinking about if we had long runs, I need to save a little bit. And when Russell was out front one time, I was just saving my stuff. If it came down to a long green flag run, hopefully that I saved a little more than him and would have something for him. And I knew it would be hard to pass on the low side, but if it played out, I was going to give it a try there at the end.
I'm sure you were, but you won the race, man. You did a great job, Bobby. And, you know, you persevered. Now, we were talking a little bit about the tempers flaring here at FTSR. You know, we've had a little bit of temper through Texas. Now we head to Bristol and have a race like this. It's going to escalate a little bit. I mean, we're heading to tracks like Martinsville, Richmond, Dover. Is it going to be tough out there? I mean, the drivers have long memories.
Oh yeah, I'm sure it will be. I mean, I love short tracks, but I mean, like I said, they can bring out, you know, the tempers in everyone a little bit, you know. And I don't think anyone means anything by it, but they just make bad decisions sometimes, and you know, and it hurts some feelings, and it happens.
It definitely does. You know, and you talked about you love short tracks. Well, this is your first win in the trucks at Bristol. I mean, we see you run up front a lot, but you got to be extremely happy, man, to nail Bristol down and put that on the shelf.
Oh, yeah. I was winning Bristol, you know, in the trucks. Yeah, checklist, done. It felt good. And Zach probably had a good truck too, but he got involved in a wreck, you know, so I forgot about him. He's usually strong every week. So like I said, there was, you know, five or six guys that either one of us could have won the race by track position or whatever. I mean, it's just, you got to have some luck here. And then, like I said, and make the right pit stops and then try to get that track position.
Yeah, you definitely need a little luck. We talked about that. I mean, you had the luck, you had the skill, you had the truck, and now you have the victory and the trophy. Congratulations, Bobby. And, you know, we wish you all the best going forward at these short tracks, man. Hope you can keep her clean out there. Anyway, any shout-outs you want to give or anything, now's the time, brother.
I'd like to thank you guys up in the booth, Jared, Dean. You know, do a good job. Thanks for doing it. I know it takes time, and I appreciate y'all doing it. FTSR, the league as a whole, couldn't do it without, you know, all the admins. You guys run an awesome league, and I mean, it's fun. And then Blackwater for sponsoring this series. And then, you know, I shout out to all the drivers. A lot of we all gave room tonight when I come up on them, you know, so I want to thank them.
All right. Congrats, Bobby.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, that's Bobby Terrell, our winner tonight of the Bristol 200 here at Bristol Motor Speedway with Blackwater Products USA. Jared, what more can we say about Bobby Terrell?
What a racer. I mean, I can't believe this is his first win at Bristol, his first short track win in the truck series. Huge night for him. And on top of that, he's our unofficial points leader going into the next race.
Yeah, he'll pick up the points lead there. And we'll catch back up with him a week from Wednesday. We're actually off next week. And Jared, now where are we at next Wednesday?
We are going to be at Richmond. So another short track right off the bat.
So we talked about those tracks. I wasn't sure which one, but a week from Wednesday, we're going to go short track, and we're going to see if any of these memories come into play. So join us then. And we also got a week from this Saturday, we got Vidane Racing, and that's a Super Speedway Series, the Rent-A-Race-Car Super Speedway Series. Great action over there. Some hard Super Speedway, but these guys, man, they put it three wide all the time. Highly entertaining, quality racing over there at Vidane Racing as well. But until then, we're going to sign off tonight, and that's it here from Bristol Motor Speedway.